Hello everyone. In this video, I am discussing the topic AC through series RL circuit. Consider a circuit with a resistance R and inductance L are connected across an AC source. The source voltage is Vm sin omega t. Here, XL is the inductive reactance of the coil. Vr represent voltage drop across resistance and VL represent voltage drop across this coil. I is the current flowing through the circuit. Next, we have to draw the phasor diagram. For that, first current is taken as the reference vector and VR is the voltage across resistance. It is in phase with current. In a pure resistance, voltage and current are in phase with each other. Next, we have to draw VL. VL is voltage across inductive law, inductor. So, VL is lead by an angle 90 degree. The resultant voltage V is vector sum of VR and VL. So, this is our resultant voltage. And the angle between current and voltage is taken as phi. Let capital V is RMS value of voltage and capital I is RMS value of current and VR is voltage across resistor, that is I into R, and VL is voltage across inductive load, that is I into XL. Here, XL is omega L, that is equal to 2 pi F into L. So, the resultant voltage V can be written as root of VR square plus VL square. That is equal to root of IR all square plus I into XL all square. So, V equal to I into root of R square plus XL square. By rearranging the equation, I equal to V divided by root of R square plus XL square. It is equal to V divided by Z. Z is impedance of the circuit. And it is equal to root of R square plus XL square. And from the phasor diagram, we can able to write tan phi equal to VL divided by VR. It is equal to I into XL divided by I into R. That is equal to XL divided by R. That is reactance divided by resistance. Tan phi equal to reactance divided by resistance. Or we can able to say phi equal to tan inverse XL divided by R. From the phasor diagram, we can able to draw a voltage triangle. This is VL, VR, this is resultant voltage. VL equal to I into XL, VR equal to I into R, and V equal to I into Z, and this angle is phi. This triangle is called voltage triangle, and this triangle can be simplified and this is XL, this is R, and this side is Z, and this angle is phi, and the resultant triangle is called impedance triangle. And one more point from the phasor diagram. See the phasor diagram. This is the resultant voltage and this is our current. The current is lagging by an angle phi. So we can able to write that the instantaneous value of voltage V equal to Vm sin omega t, and instantaneous value of current I equal to Im sin omega t minus phi. So in a series RL circuit, current is always lags by an angle phi. Next, we have to draw the phasor diagram of this. This is our voltage waveform. Next is current. Current is always lags by an angle phi. Current complete the initial portions. Next, we have to draw the power. Power is the product of voltage and current. In the first region, voltage is positive, current is negative. So power is negative. In the next portion, both voltage and current are positive. So the product of voltage and current is positive. In the next region, current is positive but voltage is negative. So power become negative. In the next region, both voltage and current are negative. That means the product is positive. And in the next section, power will be negative. So this is our instantaneous value of power. Graph shows variations of power. Next, we have to calculate the average value of power in the circuit. We know that in a pure inductive coil, the average value of power is zero. So the resultant power is only due to resistive element. So power equal to VR into I. The reason is that pure inductor average power becomes zero. And from the triangle, we can able to say that VR equal to V cos phi. So average value of power become V I cos phi. This is the average value of power in a series RL circuit. Thank you.